Hi, let's talk about miscellaneous supplies that you're going to need as well through the course of the project. Now, sometimes, depending on what surface we're doing or the particular project, there will be some oddities that will happen in there, but we'll talk about those when the time comes. For the most part, you're going to need some type of transfer paper. We carry the Sorrel wax-free. It does need to be wax-free. You cannot use carbon paper here. Super Choco paper is another good option. It comes in black, blue and white. This has an assortment of 5 different colors, so no matter what type of background colors you've got, you can transfer your pattern onto it with that. Make sure you have some type of transfer paper at your painting table. You're going to need probably some painter's tape at some point in time. As you noticed, I've got my Strathmore canvas paper taped onto an expensive plywood board. I also have MDF boards that I use. 1/8 inch MDF works really great there. And it just helps to keep the paper on. When I'm painting on canvas, when we get to that stage, you're also going to see that I will tape my canvas paper right onto this as well. And the reason I do that is it gives me a good sturdy background for painting on my easel. That's the other thing I want to talk to you about, is an easel and why it's beneficial to have it. When you're painting a landscape, a seascape, a still life, anything of that type of nature, in other words, you're not painting on a wood surface, an easel is best. And the reason for that is because it gets your project up and in view the same way you'd be looking at it in nature. You're not painting something that is placed at a 45-degree angle to you or a 90-degree angle to you. You're painting something that you're looking on straight on. And the easel will give you that opportunity to get it up and off. It also will give you an opportunity to keep your arms out of that wet paint. And you'll find that all in all, it's a very beneficial tool. Now, my easel is, as many of you may know, I have extremely disabled knees. So I cannot stand. I have to sit. I love this tabletop easel because this canvas tray here that holds the canvas, the canvas guard, will drop. This little has a little pin back here. I can't even think what you call them, but it's just a little twist pin that lets me unscrew very quickly. Will drop this guard below the edge of my table here so that when I'm working on huge canvases, I'm not having to stretch my arms up so high and my body up and out to try and reach the top of that canvas. This will drop it from this point here that you can see all the way down to this pin. So it really will accommodate a large canvas. Now I got this, and I got several for the studio here. You can probably see one in the background here in the picture for the students at Hobby Lobby. And I actually, you know, Hobby Lobby's awful good about giving you 40% discount coupons if you sign up for their internet newsletter or if you get their newspaper ads. So just take that in and get one of these. They're under, oh gosh, I think they're right around $39, $49 in my area here in Colorado. And with my 40% off, it cost me like $26, $28. The other thing that I love about this is that, again, the way that this one drops, the guard at the top raises. Now I'm going to adjust the camera here real quickly so you can see how that is. That guard goes all the way up there. See it? And that is at its full height extension now. But as you can see, I've got a clip here which allows me to put a copy of the project, of the photo of the project that I'm working on, so that it's always within reach. If I'm working on a canvas and really going to be pushing hard against that canvas, then I will grab that upper bracer bar and drop it down to tighten up and onto this canvas board or canvas paper or whatever it is, or surface that I'm using here. But I like the fact that it has some versatility to it. The other fact that I absolutely love about that, and I'm not sure if I told you about that earlier or not, I'm a little senile, as you probably know, is that all of these easels are portable so that I can take them with me. They all collapse down, and this little piece will, believe it or not, actually sit inside here on the back so that when this piece folds back and drops down, I can take this with me and it'll just tighten right in there, and it goes and ports right along with it. But the other nice thing is that over here on the right side, there is an empty space that this little drawer fits into. Look how nice these 1 ounce jars of Genesis paints will fit in there. If you love to paint at your craft shows and you're going to be using Genesis, of course, you don't have to have all these paints with you. You'll find this is pretty handy. When I was doing demonstrations last year, I found that I could just pack this up so quickly. These 1 ounce jars fit in here, slides into the base of this box here, and go right along with me. Awesome stuff. And it all snaps in, so I don't have to worry about it, and I'm ready to go. I just put a little bit of paint thinner in one of my small plastic jars that I have for storage, and away we go. Okay, what are some of the other things that we're going to need? Obviously, painter's tape, because you're going to want to be taping some of this stuff onto your backing, or taping off different sections that perhaps we'll be doing a special technique with, and we'll need to have it. It's a wonderful resource. If you don't have it, you'll need it. Get some. Okay. Again, I've already talked to you about the Mona Lisa cleaning tank. You're going to need this, or you're going to need some type of water basin for your acrylics. With the Genesis, we'll be using the Mona Lisa odorless thinner, not only for cleaning our brushes for quick color changes, but we'll also be painting with it, quite believe it or not. So make sure you have some of that handy if you're using the Genesis. The other thing you're going to need is, of course, your pencil for allowing you to transfer your paper or your pattern onto your surface, your palette knife. This little thing, you probably don't even know what this is, but it's called a wipeout tool. It's a rubber. It almost feels like a pencil eraser. And what it is it actually is a paint eraser. The wipeout tool allows you, and I'm sure at some point you'll see me using it, allows me to go in and clean up an edge where needed. It allows me to actually swipe off some paint if I've made a mistake, put the wrong color on, put it where it didn't need to be, whatever. I use these quite a bit, and especially for line definition. They've got a real, even though it's a soft rubber, they've got a nice little pointy tip to them, like this one, and also on this one on the diagonal. And that is just very, very handy for cleaning up edges. The other thing that might be helpful at some point is Q-tips. I can't tell you how many times I've grabbed into these, and I can't even tell you right now why, other than I've obviously made a mistake somewhere. So it probably wouldn't hurt to have some of these at your table. I keep mine covered because I have kitties who like to thief them. Takes off with them every chance he gets. He's such a little stinker. Okay. You know, I think that's it. Are you ready to get started painting? I sure am. Let's go for it. See you on the next clip. We're going to start technique videos. Bye-bye.